for surely my spirit will rest upon you as one. Today you have become one. And now you can expect those things which you have hidden in your heart, desires that you said, when God, when will this come to pass? When will this be? Now it will be, says the Lord. Those things that have been there deep within you, now it shall be for this appointed time, for this season. Now it will come as two have become one. Allan, this has got to be the coolest wedding I have ever been at. It's just a guy who does as many weddings as you, you know how to pull it off. And so it is a fantastic day to be here.
Can I kiss her now?
Oh, no. It's just that self-restraint. It'll go a long way.
Carr is a truly loving and caring person who will always be there for a friend in need. She's a very dutiful daughter who has taken care of her mom, a thoughtful sister, as well as a really caring auntie for her nieces and nephews.
And I don't know how you courted or romanced Carmelita. It's still a mystery to some of us. But anyhow, you did it, and well done. I wonder, how did Adam court Eve? You know, he might have had some pickup lines like, "Do you come here often?" You know, you're the only one for me. Trust me, baby, this was meant to be. Or he might have said, look around, baby, all the other guys are animals.
And had a feeling that something forever might come. So I started making memories of it and drawing these flowers.
We're really hardwired for love, for feelings of love. And no greater place than a wedding where we really see the feelings of love. And we see it in your lives today. And yet, love is more than a feeling. Love is often a choice. It's an action.
Said, Allan, I love you more than anyone in all the world, but I love Jesus more. That gave me more confidence in my relationship with Carmelita than anything. Anyone that knows us well would know that our giftings and our talents are polar opposites. And my prayer is that never become an irritant, but that we always see it as a gift from God. Because I believe that the two of us together can become something that neither of us ever could be alone.
At last.
And now watch what I will do through your lives. Things that you both have had deep resident there, I will bring them to the surface, and it will flower, it will bloom, and it will have fruit. And the fruit will contain a seed, and that seed will be planted here and there, and yes, even other places. It will produce my nature, my glory, and many others through your lives, says the Lord.